I think one of the interesting things that's happened since we've come to cross country is that we've been able to provide this amazing program over the summer. And for us, it was a new start, it was a new beginning. It was about exposing the kids to something a little bit different than what they were exposed to at Collington. So our main goal was that we were gonna bring them into an environment where there were trees and grass, and you know, the teaching structure was different here, the actual school itself was different, there was more discipline. And we wanted to expose the kids at Collington to this whole new environment.
Bend down, isn't it a pity? Doesn't seem to be a shadow in the city. All around, people looking half dead, walking on the sidewalk harder than a match head. But now it's a different world. Go out and find a girl.
We're going to walk down the hall and we're going to go to all of our classrooms. Right now from 8:30 until 11:45, kids are in academics. Part of the grant that we have to fund this program is from the Maryland State Department of Education. And they require that we spend at least an hour every day doing academics. They have an hour and a half of math, an hour and a half of reading and language arts. After that, then they go into their micro society, in which we create this mini society within the program. The kids have jobs, they run the government, it's their society.
Our seventh graders run the government, and one of the things that they were supposed to do was create City Hall. So this is their poster of City Hall, and one of the other things that they were going to do was create the constitution for our society. Part of what we're going to do today is that they're going to present the constitution to the society in a town hall meeting, and we have to vote on it so that we can ratify it and get it into law. So that's one of the things we're going to do later today, but this is just an example of the kinds of things that we're doing in micro society, in which we're actually creating a society and we're teaching them how to live within the society that they created.
Part of y'all being a manager in the restaurant is that you have to manage it. It's not her responsibility to manage it, it's your responsibility as the manager to manage your business. These are your workers, okay?
Away they go. On the first leg for Great Britain, way, way out in lane number six, Martin Wimbell Lewis. But way in front now, for America, Rod Freeman.
We're going to be talking about things that can help you in life. Life skills. What are some of the skills that you need to practice in order to make it in life?
For this last week, with International Medalist Association, have brought in Olympic camp. So we are competing with various Olympic games, from long jump and relays. We have hurdles. So we're really excited to bring that to the kids.
I look forward to this camp every year. This is my fourth year. And as Olympians, we always want to give back, not only through our physical knowledge of the activities that we represented the United States, but also to talk to the young kids about being good students, being good citizens. So we sort of incorporate not only the physical activities of hurdling, starting with and doing sprints, relay races. But we also talk about good character, leadership, attitudes, trust, all of those things that are important to just being a person.
Just a bit of a breath from the north. Just a little something to
what we found, even at Collington, and we're finding it again here, is that a lot of the kids are out of the classroom, not because they're suspended out of school, but they're suspended out of the classroom. So they have a lot of out of classroom time that they could be learning, but they're sitting in the office, or they're at the counselor's, or because their behavior doesn't warrant them being in the classroom.
No,
we're not doing this today.
They were upstairs.
We're not doing this.
They were upstairs and they had son, there was no teacher with you.
We're not doing this. Go into the cafeteria and sit in there until I get ready. All of y'all. Part of our program and part of the goal of our program is to reach out to those guys and kind of touch them, provide programming around them so that they know and understand that they have a value and that they have a place. Let's do this. Can you just finish this next hour for me and sitting there and do your work for me? Okay. And work with the story and work with Ms. Buchanan so we can finish this last hour out. Okay. Can I have a handshake? Thank you. Okay. You ready to go back in? Oh, yeah.
I'm Jada Jackson. I'm in sixth grade. I've been in the program for 1 year. The thing I like about the program is that I get to meet different people and people I didn't, like my first year at the school, I didn't know no one. So got to make some new friends and met some new people I didn't really know. We made Play-Doh out of baking soda and water and stuff. It was interesting.
My name is Andre McCoy and I go to Cotton Square and I'm in the eighth grade. And I've been inside the program for 6 years, since I was in third grade. And things I like about this program is it's a whole bunch of fun. Like the things that we do, go outside, go on trips, go swimming, do plays, a whole lot of things inside the 21st century.
When you were doing the jogging around the track, how many laps were you able to do?
20.
20 laps, good job, good job. What else did you do in the summer?
Did my word search.
Hmm?
I did my word search.
Word searches? We really have to understand that we have a place in these kids' lives. And when we come in to do these kinds of programs, it's not just a babysitter. We're there to really impart and to uplift and to motivate them and to help them dream and to help them understand that their dreams, I know it's cliche, but their dreams really can come true. And if they really work hard, then there's nothing that they can't accomplish. It's just absolutely nothing.
See what you can find.